In this tutorial, we'll show how to define a new PV module that can be used in the PVsyst simulations. We'll go through the main PV module's definitions in PVsyst, which are stored in so-called PAN files, by defining a new module based on a datasheet. The first page of a datasheet describes general features of the PV module, which are usually promotional. The second page gives the technical specifications, most importantly, the short circuit current ISC, the maximum power point described by the current IMP and the voltage VMP, and the open circuit voltage VOC. Most of the times, several power classes of the same PV module are gathered together on a single datasheet. It is possible to create new PV modules from scratch in the PVsyst database, but in practice, it is much easier to start from a similar PV module that is already present in the database, modify the main parameters according to the datasheet, and store it under a new name. We choose a generic module for this example. After selecting the PV module from the list, click on Open. When opening a new PV module or any component in PVsyst, you must define the basic data, which are model, manufacturer, data source, and file name. The convention in PVsyst is to define the file name of PV modules as manufacturer_model.pan. The first page of the dialog shows the main properties, which are the definitions of the SDC specifications, a summary of the model parameters, and a tool that calculates the results of the one diode model for given irradiance and temperature conditions. Fill in the respective values from the datasheet. First, there is a nominal or nameplate power PNOM together with its tolerances and the model technology. Next, you need to enter the STC values. STC stands for standard test conditions and means values given for an irradiance of 1000 watt per square meter, a cell temperature of 25 degrees centigrade, and a light spectrum corresponding to an air mass of 1.5. Fill in the basic values at STC conditions for ISC, VOC, IMP, and VMP for this module. Many datasheets mention these operating parameters also for NOCT conditions. This information is not used in PVsyst. Finally, fill in the ISC temperature coefficient mu ISC, which is often named alpha on the datasheet. Click on Sizes and Technology. It is mandatory to define the size of the module. It is also mandatory to define the number of cells in series and in parallel. Please note that this concerns how the cells are electrically connected. Typically, these are 60 or 72 cells in series and one in parallel. It does not mean the number of cells as geometrically arranged in the PV module, as often specified on the datasheets. The cell area is optional. If defined, it will allow to calculate the efficiency at the cell level. For the maximal array voltage, the IEC value is usually 1000 volt for standard PV modules. Nowadays, more and more modules are specified for 1500 volts to be used in high voltage PV systems. In the US, some modules are specified for 600 volt due to special regulation rules for electrical systems. In this field, you enter the number of protection bypass diodes. This concerns operational bypass diodes, which define the submodules that are used in the module layout tool. Sometimes manufacturers connect two diodes in parallel, which makes six diodes for a standard PV module. In the PAN file, this has to be accounted for as three operational bypass diodes. The submodule partition for most usual modules has to be defined as in length. For the special twin half-cut cells modules, you should check this box. For this new technology of PV modules, the number of cells in series is normally 60 or 72, and the number of cells in parallel should be set to 2. For bifacial PV modules, you have to check the option Bifacial Module and specify the bifaciality factor. The bifaciality factor is the only parameter defining a bifacial module. This free text field allows you to describe special properties or features of the module in up to 4 lines. The Model Parameters page defines the parameters that are specific to the PVsyst one diode model. They do not show up on the datasheets. Some of these parameters are derived from the values entered in the Basic Data tab. On this page, you should leave R-Serie and R-Shunt at their default value, meaning that the checkboxes should be checked. The R-Serie value mainly determines the low light performance of the PV module. The default value set by PVsyst for crystalline silicon is -3% at 200 watt per square meter. If this value is not reachable, the value for R-Shunt should be increased. In the lower part, you find specific parameters determined by the model. Here the mu VOC temperature coefficient is a result of the model. It will not necessarily match the value on the datasheet. The tab R-Shunt exponential shows how the shunt resistance depends on the irradiance. In the absence of measured values, leave these parameters at their default values. The temperature coefficient page describes the temperature dependence of the maximum power point. Here, you should enter the PMPP temperature coefficient as given in the datasheet, where it is usually called gamma. This is a fundamental parameter for the simulation. PVsyst slightly modifies the standard one diode model to ensure that this value is exactly matched. The additional data page contains optional data, which is normally not found on the datasheet. If you have information on these values, you can fill them in, else you should leave the fields empty or at their default values. Mostly, it is a customized IAM page where you might want to make a change. Here, you define the IAM function based on the Fresnel's laws. The default is for a normal glass. You should choose AR coating only if this is explicitly mentioned on the datasheet. Now the PV module is fully defined and we can have a look at the results for the one diode model. On the basic data page on the bottom left part, you find the internal model result tool that calculates the electrical behavior of the PV module for any irradiance and temperature conditions. On the graphs page, you can get a more complete picture of the model behavior. You can see several plots for this PV module, like the IV curves or, for example, the low light efficiency. Now the PV module is fully defined. When exiting this dialog, PVsyst will prompt you to save your modifications. Clicking on Save will store this new PAN file in your PVsyst workspace and you will be able to use it in your projects.